All right, let's do Tai Chi. What is Tai Chi? Tai Chi. Many people have heard of it. Many people have studied it or want to study it, but can't find a teacher, can't learn from video, find the movements hard to do. There's any number of scenarios. So what I'm going to teach you today is pared down Tai Chi. I'm going to teach you Tai Chi without the form. Okay, because the form takes months to learn. A lot of people have a hard time dedicating that much time to something. The positive effects to be had from doing Tai Chi is through the movements and not the form. So I'm going to show you how to move. First thing we need to do is walk. How do you walk? How do we walk in Tai Chi? How do we walk in general? A lot of people lean forward and fall into their steps. Okay? That throws your body out of alignment. It causes more muscles to be used than needs to be. It's jarring to the body. That's not Tai Chi walking. In Tai Chi, you keep your spine erect and centered. Keep your knees bent. That helps. Gets rid of a little bit of this curve in the spine because it tilts the pelvis a little. And you keep your chin tucked just a little bit to help straighten the spine. And that way, the spine becomes like a straight pole that you balance with. That's how you hold your body in Tai Chi. How to step. Stepping is done heel to toe shift. So it's 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. It's shifting your weight onto your foot after it's flat on the ground, after you feel the ground. Like a cat when it's sneaking up on someone or something. It puts its feet down and then slowly shifts the weight onto that foot. That's what you're doing in this. And that's why you put your heel down first. So you just step out, let your foot come down to a distance that is comfortable, flatten the foot, shift your weight. Then you do that with the other foot. Flatten the foot, shift your weight. Flatten your foot, shift your weight. So heel, toe, shift. Heel, toe, shift. That cups down on the jarring and it helps make it more meditative. Now the other part of walking you need to be aware of is to help keep your balance. And there's two things to do to keep your balance. One I've already mentioned, which is bending your knees. Okay, bending your knees will help you with your balance. The other thing is crescent walking. Taking a step, come in and going out. Come in and going out. That's crescent walking. You can do it backwards. Now when you step backwards, it's toe, heel, shift. Toe, heel, shift. Crescent walking helps give you length and width in your stance. If you have no width, and you step one foot in front of the other, you're out of balance. If you have width and no length, you're stable this way, but not stable to the front or the back. So we compromise, we do a little of both. We have length and width, and the way to help that is by taking a crescent step. So if I wanted to walk towards you right now, I would tack like a sailboat upwind. Okay, step, heel, toe, shift. So I'm going off a little bit this way, then I crescent step, heel, toe, shift. Now I'm going this direction. All the while I'm actually going straight ahead, but in a zigzag sort of way. Toe, heel, toe, shift. That's how you step doing Tai Chi. So now we know how to walk. How do we make walking into a Tai Chi sort of exercise to get the benefits of doing Tai Chi? We slowly walk, rock, and breathe. Four things. Now you can start out a little bit faster and work into slowness if you need to. Or you may, if you're too amped up, need to go run or exercise or do something before you try slowing down. Okay, so what do I mean by slowly walk, rock, and breathe? Rocking relaxes your body, puts you in a semi-trance state. Adults rock little babies, or people sit in rocking chairs and rock. If you go to the zoo and watch a big elephant, they're rocking. Animals know how to rock. We know how to rock. What we're doing here is doing it purposely for an effect. When you shift all your weight into one leg, those muscles tighten up and the other muscles loosen. And then as you slowly shift your weight from one leg to the other, the leg that was relaxed is now tight, and the leg that was tight is now relaxed. What does that do to you? When you're slowly tensing and relaxing your muscles, you're kind of, it's like doing a self-massage. And you do that long enough, the muscles get warm and they get relaxed. And the pumping action from tightening and relaxing your muscles pump lymph and blood through your body and qi. The lymphatic system is dependent upon one-way valves. When the muscles tense, it pumps it up. So it's pump, relax, pump, relax, pump. It gets your juices flowing. That's one of the benefits of doing Tai Chi. Relaxing, getting your fluids flowing, your qi flowing, calming the mind. So it's great for stress and stress-related illnesses. So we rock. How do we do that? If we step, so you might want to put your hand in the over the area of your belly button for now. Heel, toe, shift. Now rock. And then take a step. Heel, toe, shift. Now it's good to practice this on flat surface if you can, especially if you're a beginner. I'm on an uneven surface and it can throw you off initially. Okay, so that's what I mean by rocking. Now, breathing, how do you add breathing to it? Well, every time you go forward, you exhale. And every time you come back, you inhale. Now, if you're moving slowly, that means you're breathing slowly. That slows down your body and helps you get more relaxed. Then the only other thing you may want to add is putting your hands over here or over here initially and just work the bottom half of your body and get used to it. But eventually you may want to add your hands. And a simple thing to add is just a push. And a relax coming back and a push. Now it's not a hard, we don't tense push. But we push in a, we don't have a word in English actually for this. So I'm going to describe it using metaphor. Imagine A stack of boxes filled with comforters. Not very heavy. Doesn't take much energy to move that stack. And of course, another important feature is smiling. Smiling helps relax your muscles and helps open up the flow of energy in your body. It gives you endorphins and makes you feel good. So if you're frustrated, you might visualize pushing that frustration away and inhaling positive smiling energy. And that's basic, simple, bare bones Tai Chi. If you take what I've shown you, how to walk, taking a crescent step, putting your heel down, flattening your foot, and shifting. One, two, three, rock. Breathe. When you're done, refocus to the center of your body, lower your belly button, smile, and you've done Tai Chi. So if it's winter time, see how long it can take you to walk across your living room. And you can, if you start out at one speed, try slowing it down. Feel your body. Don't power through the moves, but slowly move and feel the movement. Become aware and focused on your body. And you're doing Tai Chi. So I hope this is helpful. I hope you can spend some time trying this out. Give yourself 5 or 10 minutes of doing this. You'll be amazed how you feel at the end. You'll feel relaxed and yet energized. And that's great. That's a great way to start the day or do it after work or do it at the end of the day just to decompress. It's a great exercise. Eventually I'll put some videos on how to do Tai Chi, the form. There's lots of benefits from knowing the form, but that doesn't mean you can't start reaping the benefits right away. This will help you do that. All right, be well and have fun.